Hello friends, today we are gonna see how to install power devices like motion sensor, glass break detector and shock sensor in Taxicom control panel. In order to do that, we will be required following BOQ, Taxicom control panel, Taxicom motion sensor or any other motion sensor, glass break detector and shock sensor. As you can see in picture, control panel Elite 88 and 168 will have 4 terminal zone 2 and control panel Elite 24 and 64W will have 2 terminal zone 2. So we have to do the cabling for the normally closed and normally open devices. So normally closed devices will go to the zone and will use 2 port out of 4, one for the A first and then E last for the normally closed and normally open devices in 4 terminal zone port in Elite 88 and 168. In 2 terminal zone port, straight away 2 cable will go to the zone directly for normally closed and normally open devices. This is how the panel connection will. So now let's see what we are gonna get on Taxicom motion sensor or any third party power devices. So on third party power devices, normally we'll get a 4 port, one 12 volt plus, second 12 volt minus and 2 port for the alarm. But generally there are many sensors which come with 6 core or 6 port, you can say. So 6 ports are 12 volt positive, negative, alarm, 2 ports, tamper, 2 port. So this is how it's gonna be for power devices: 12 volt positive, negative, alarm, 2 port and tamper, 2 port. So this is how any power device is gonna be. So now let's see how to connect power devices to control panel directly. Firstly, we have to draw the power from control panel, that is 12 volt positive and negative. So this is how it's gonna be. Then we have to draw a 2 core cable from alarm to zone. So we are laying a cable from alarm port to panel zone port. So A first port and T last port for the alarm connection. This is normally closed connection. Then again from the alarm port, we have to draw 2 cable to the zone port, that is A first and T last, and the same for the shock sensor. So this is how the simple normally closed or normally open connection is gonna be for the PIR, glass break detector and shock sensor. If you wanted to use the tamper, you can draw again a 2 core cable from a tamper and you have to assign to the any zone. If you wanted to do a parallel connection for all the sensors, you can do that, but in order to do that, we have to assign whatever zone you are going to use, you have to assign that zone as a tamper zone. This is how the simple connection for the power device is going to be.
Thank you.